नमस्कार, स्वागतम सुस्वागतम। आज के इस महत्वपूर्ण अवसर पर मैं आप सभी उपस्थित जनों का हार्दिक स्वागत और अभिनंदन करती हूँ। कार्यक्रम में मैं विशेष रूप से स्वागत अभिनंदन करना चाहूँगी हमारे डीजी माननीय डॉक्टर मांडे सर, आदरणीय डॉक्टर माशेलकर सर, आदरणीय डॉक्टर शिवराम सर, डॉक्टर विजय मोहन जी, डॉक्टर चंद्रशेखर, डॉक्टर आशीष, आप सभी उपस्थित एटोडीज का भी हार्दिक हार्दिक स्वागत और अभिनंदन है। इसी के साथ मैं कार्यक्रम से जुड़े आप सभी सम्मानित जनों की ऑनलाइन ऑफलाइन उपस्थिति को नमन करती हूँ। कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत करना चाहेंगे, मैं आरंभ में निवेदन करूंगी माननीय डॉक्टर एस चंद्र, कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत इससे पहले कि डॉक्टर चंद्रशेखर जी अपना उद्बोधन प्रदान करें, फ्लोरल वेलकम से हम करना चाहेंगे। मेरा निवेदन है माननीय डॉक्टर जोशी सर से, बहुत धन्यवाद। और इसी के साथ मेरा निवेदन है माननीय डॉक्टर आशीष लेले जी से, माननीय डॉक्टर माशेलकर सर का पुष्प गुच्छ देकर। और कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत करना चाहूंगी, मैं विनम्र निवेदन करूंगी माननीय डॉक्टर एस चंद्रशेखर सर से, कार्यक्रम में प्रस्तावित भाषण प्रदान करें और साथ ही आज के दिनांक से माननीय डॉक्टर आशीष लेले जी को निदेशक का कार्यभार संबंधित सारी कार्यवाही पूर्ण करें। डॉक्टर एस चंद्रशेखर,
थैंक यू, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। डॉक्टर माशेलकर नमस्कार सर, शिवराम जी नमस्कार, डॉक्टर शेखर मांडे नमस्कार, एंड ऑल द फ्रेंड्स, आशीष वेलकम ऑन बोर्ड। इट्स सच एन ऑनर टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस इवेंट। यू हैव शोन द वे वन डायरेक्टर हैज टू टेक चार्ज। आई थिंक द करेंट डीजी, द फॉर्मर डीजी एंड द प्रीवियस डायरेक्टर्स आर ऑल पार्ट ऑफ दिस विटनेस, शोज हाउ पॉपुलर यू आर अमॉन्ग्स द एनसीएल कम्युनिटी। वेलकम ऑन बोर्ड अगेन। And while I've already signed the guard, change of guard signature and has been passed on to Pooja, hopefully. So Pooja, from now, Ashish will be our new director of National Chemical Laboratory, Pune. Ashish, formally welcome on board. And while the dignity is on call, I would not like to say many words. But certainly, NCL, I had the privilege of serving for the last 4 months when Ashwini has given me the charge. I think same day, I requested Sunil Joshi to act on my behalf for day-to-day affairs. And we made a small group of scientists, and which was led by Dr. Sunil Joshi and ably supported by Prasad, Asha, Prabhakaran and Deshpande. I do believe my absence was not felt in Pune while I have traveled twice and interacted with most of the colleagues. But the way Joshi has conducted this institute, and I sincerely thank Ashwini for giving the direction on how Sunil has been an able supporter when Ashwini was the director of the organization. And this group of scientists have done exceedingly well. And I also would like to place on record my special thanks to Director Secretariat. Both the officers in the director's office have been making all the emails coming in director's account weekly twice, sharing the entire list with the group of scientists and also to me. to make sure that no email is unanswered. I think I sincerely thank both the officers in the Data Secretariat. I'm sure I request Ashish that these two would certainly be an asset to you while you are taking charge today. I also would like to thank Dr. Mashelkar, Dr. Shivaram, and all the leaders of NCL who have built a platform, and I again steal the words of Ashwini, a well-oiled engine does not require a director. And I think that's what NCL is. Whether director is in place or not, the lab runs on its own. The colleagues know what they have to do. And I think it's an honor and privilege to be serving NCL, because you will not spend so much time in administration. I think you will have all the time for you to do whatever good science you would like to do and the strategy you would like to give to the institute. So welcome on board, Ashish, again, and thank you for this opportunity. Over back to you, NCL.
Couldn't hear, Satish.
Joshi, I think I lost voice, maybe. Back to you.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah,
धन्यवाद डॉक्टर चंद्रशेखर जी. पिछले दिनों आपने जिस शिद्दत के साथ एनसीएल को संभाला है और आपका हमें मार्गदर्शन प्राप्त हुआ है, मैं पूरे सीएसआईआर एनसीएल परिवार की ओर से आपका हार्दिक धन्यवाद देती हूँ. और आपका साथ और आपका मार्गदर्शन आगे भी हमें मिलता रहेगा, यह उम्मीद हमारे एनसीएल वासियों की तरफ से करती हूँ. आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. और इसी के साथ मैं आगे कार्यक्रम में आगे बढ़ते हुए माननीय डॉक्टर आशीष सेले जी से निवेदन करना चाहूंगी कि वे इस अवसर पर चंद्र शब्द हैं, लेकिन इससे पहले जो हम पूरे एनसीएल वासियों का जो आपके प्रति शुभकामना है वह व्यक्त करूंगी कि हमारे पूरे सीएसआईआर परिवार की है यह बधाई और शुभकामना. कि यश फैले, जयवंत हो पूर्ण सभी काम, गुंजित हो आपके नेतृत्व में हमारे एनसीएल का नाम. इसी के साथ मैं आपसे निवेदन करूंगी कि इस अवसर पर चंद्र शब्द से कहें. ले
Chandrasekhar, first, I would like to express on behalf of NCL our gratitude for leading us in the past 4 months. And I want to personally thank you for taking care of NCL despite your very busy schedule. I can only imagine how difficult it must be to run two large laboratories of CSIR. I know that Sunil and Bhupi and others have very ably supported you. So my sincere thanks to all of you as well. These are not very easy times to lead a research laboratory. So, in view of all of this, thanks very much. We greatly appreciate your leadership. And I'm looking forward, Chandra, to work with you very closely to build close ties with IIST and NCL. So, we look forward to working together in the near future. Thank you very much. So, my dear friends of NCL, I'm not half as good as director as Dr. Mashelkar is and not as equipped as Dr. Shivaram is. So I'm going to read my address to you today. I accept with great humility the responsibility of becoming the director of this great institution, the National Chemical Laboratory of CSIR. I joined NCL 28 years ago, almost exactly to this day. These have been the most glorious years of my professional life. Although I spent the past 2 years outside NCL, the laboratory was very much in my heart, and I feel privileged to have been given the opportunity to come back and to lead NCL. First and foremost, I would like to thank from the bottom of my heart Dr. Mashelkar, Dr. Shekhar Mande, Dr. Shivaram, and all the dignitaries who are participating online for sparing your valuable time to raise this event. The entire NCL community needs your blessings, support, and mentoring to achieve bigger and greater things than the sum of all of the competencies put together. There are a few venerable leaders who are unfortunately not amongst us today. I'm sure every day that you are watching us from up there and showering upon us your unconditional love. I'm going to miss you very dearly. This laboratory, under the leadership of many great visionaries, has always given new directions to not just CSIR, but to the entire science, technology, and innovation ecosystem in India. Whether it was dyestuff industries in the 50s, agrochemicals in the 60s, pharmaceuticals in the 70s, catalysis and import substitution in the 80s, patenting and internationalization of R&D in the 90s, and and creating Venture Center, a vibrant innovation hub in the new millennium, which is headed by a very dynamic leader, Dr. Prerna, who is present here today. NCL has always paved new roads. There is a unique and defining culture of this lab in which fundamental science is tightly coupled with the development of cutting-edge technology, where pilots have been translated to industrial scales and technologies IP know-how have been successfully licensed to industry. NCL has always astutely anticipated major economic, social and policy changes at national and local levels and has smartly redefined its roadmap to stay ahead of the curve. Not only have I had the good fortune to witness, experience and even participate in redefining the vision of NCL in the 90s and the 2000s along with our great leaders, I have also had the remarkable opportunity to work in India's largest private sector company for the past 2.5 years and work closely with an incredible visionary leader to help define a major energy transition for India in a rapidly changing world. NCL's vision must therefore be shaped in the context of the present and future national as well as global macroeconomic policy trends. For instance, we have all witnessed a seismic event in the past 1 year in the form of the COVID-19 pandemic. Like almost every other country, India has suffered heavily because of the pandemic. Jobs and lives have been lost, consumer demand and supply chains have been disrupted, and our GDP is expected to contract by 24% in Q1 of 2021. The government has taken admirable steps by introducing massive stimulus packages in our economy, but it will take some time to bring the economy back on track. And this will have implications on R&D budgets, including ours. We must be cognizant of this fact. On the other hand, we must remember that in every challenge lies an opportunity. Globally, the STI ecosystem has played a stellar role by developing vaccines at warp speed and bringing up new innovations in ventilators, face masks, diagnostic kits and others. CSIR has also played a fantastic role in this fight. Our labs have been at the forefront of this battle. NCL too contributed in many ways by developing many things in stocks, recycling of PPEs, as well as articulating the benefits of vaccination in the print media. But almost most importantly, we must remember that India has become a leader in the fight against the virus by supplying vaccines to the entire world, because we had the foresight and the wisdom to set up large-scale vaccine manufacturing facilities at the right time. Something similar, I must say, is happening in the clean energy domain. During the lockdown, pollution levels fell dramatically. I saw blue skies in Mumbai for the first time in my 2.5 years there. Governments across the world pushed major policy changes to support transition to clean energy. As new innovations, investor push and government policies are accelerating the increase of global share of clean energy, the interesting fact is that India is emerging as a major manufacturing hub in this domain. The Atmanirbhar initiative of the government is supporting and enabling this opportunity and helping us to make this happen. There are many more such opportunities in emerging areas like systems biology, AI, ML, digitalization, quantum computing and so on. We at NCL must be aware of all such macro trends. They are in fact visible to all of us thanks to today's information overloaded world. What we need to do is to understand their implications and learn from our predecessors of how to strategize NCL's STI roadmap in such a context. Therefore, one of the actions I would like to take is to create a technology strategy group which can provide strategic directions to our activities in fundamental research, innovation, multidisciplinary technology projects, strategic partnerships, funding opportunities, and even creation of new organizational structures to help us make meaningful contributions. We will also seek advice from knowledgeable experts at the lab level, divisional level and project levels to help us in this effort. Our vision must always be based on the core principles of our charter, which is beautifully enshrined in the motto displayed in the foyer of our laboratory. We must internalize this value because it is our most distinguishing valuable identity. Over the years, NCL has assiduously built core strengths in key areas and built a unique ecosystem. Our competencies in material science, chemical process intensification, membranes, systems biology, diagnostic, catalysis, organic synthesis, analytical sciences, among others, have been top class. As director, I will make every effort to strengthen these and channelize them in relevant and emerging technology sectors. At the same time, I will strive to strengthen the key building blocks of our ecosystem. The IP group, stronger links with venture center, contract management, MIS, and communications with the external world. But most important of all, I will strive to revitalize NCL's creativity, foster collaborations for pursuit of bigger and ambitious programs, promote events to build interactions with our stakeholders, improve infrastructure, support professional progress of scientists, staffs, and students, and improve the efficiency and transparency of administration. All administrative and research support functions of this laboratory, including my own office and the offices of HODs, must remember that our primary job is to make NCL a better place for our scientific staff so that they may excel in their work. Our research fellows, project assistants, and postdoctoral fellows are the engines of our progress and our future ambassadors to the outside world. We must create an enabling environment that fosters the creativity of these young scientists, engineers, and entrepreneurs. And I'm happy to say that three of my students are actually on this call today, and they are there as the ambassadors of NCL because we have helped them grow in this organization. Rebuilding an institution takes many years of hard work. It is certainly not the job of one person as the director of NCL. So let us together recreate NCL's glory. 20 years from today, the next generation leaders in NCL should be able to say with pride that in the decade of 2020-2030, NCL has made stellar contributions to India's growth story in at least one or more important themes. Clean energy, reversing climate change, affordable and accessible healthcare, or disruptive innovations in specialty and fine chemicals. I want to end this address by requesting our gurus to guide us, mentor us on this path. Our DG, who is here today, has promised to back us up, so let us make use of these opportunities to reimagine NCL. Thank you all for your patient hearing, and I look forward to working with you closely, shoulder to shoulder. Thank you very much.
सभी को आपसे बहुत सारी आशाएं हैं, पूरे सीएसआईआर परिवार को आपसे बहुत आशाएं हैं, और यह विश्वास भी कि आप इन आशाओं को जरूर पूर्ण कर सकेंगे और एनसीएल आपके नेतृत्व में निश्चित रूप से प्रगति करेगा। और आप शुरू से ही भाग्यशाली रहे हैं कि एनसीएल के आधार स्तंभ आदरणीय डॉक्टर माशेलकर सर और डॉक्टर शिवराम सर का आपको शुरू से ही मार्गदर्शन मिला है, तो आपको बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं। और इसी के साथ अब बारी है हमारे सीएसआईआर परिवार के डीजी माननीय डॉक्टर शेखर मंडी सर के उद्बोधन की। मैं सर को आमंत्रित करना चाहूंगी इन शब्दों के साथ, बहुआयामी आप है, बहुआयामी काज पाकर अपने बीच में पुलकित है हम आज, आदरणीय डॉक्टर मांडे सर।
थैंक यू वेरी मच डियर फ्रेंड आशीष चंद्रा, डॉक्टर माशेलकर, डॉक्टर शिवराम, देयर सो मेनी पास्ट लीडर्स ऑफ एनसीएल हू आर प्रेजेंट हियर, and there's so many well-wishers of NCL present here. Ashish, hearty welcome to the family. We are so delighted that you have accepted the offer to lead NCL on this day. I cannot help recall the history of development of S&T in India in modern contemporary times, say last 100 years or so. All of you would agree with me that the early part of last century was dominated by people like Ramans and Sahas and so on and so forth. Principally, most of them were physicists. P.C. Ray, of course, stood out as one person who was a chemist and promoted not only fundamental chemistry but also chemical industry at his own times. But by and large, it was dominated the early part of last century by the people who were following physics. The trend slowly changed, sometimes in the 1960s or so, where people pursuing chemistry and the applied fields of chemistry, some other fields, the allied fields of chemistry, not applied fields, the allied fields, they actually started taking over more and more prominence in the development of S&T in the country and also promoting industry in the country. There's an absolutely unmistakable trend since the 1960s that the people who pursue chemistry or the allied subjects, pharmaceutics, agricultural chemistry, chemical engineering in general, so on and so forth, have actually driven most of India's science and technology in the past 50 years. There are three major players that come to my mind who have driven this growth of India and rather larger science and technology. Well, of course, IIT Kanpur, that is an unmistakable school that emerged in IIT Kanpur, which has literally driven India's chemistry. And many of them actually also here in the audience who have directly come out of that particular school. There used to be what you see, the UDCT or today's ICT, also has been one of the prime drivers of this particular trend. And the third, of course, has always been National Chemical Laboratory, NCL. That has been such a proud place in CSIR and also into the entire landscape of India's growth in this particular sector. Of course, some other particular places should not forget mentioning them. The different schools that emerge, for example, in University of Hyderabad, University of Pune, Punjab University, they also contributed to the growth of overall chemistry in the country. But three unmistakable leaders have always been IIT Kanpur, ICT, and NCL. And NCL has been a great place of pride for the entire nation, only because of all the people who are present here in the audience, so many past leaders, so many well-wishers, some of them are so tall that it's very difficult to imagine that NCL has given so much leadership to India's science and technology over the last 50, 60 years. It's quite overwhelming. And Ashish, the very fact that all of these people are present here online is a tribute to the fact that NCL as an organization and the fact that you are taking over today as the director, you have all the support from all of us to take NCL forward. Please do not hesitate in taking bold decisions. Please do not look back in you think what is right to be done and taking the agenda of taking India science and technology forward very, very aggressively. We all have to do it together and we look forward to your leadership for doing that. I should also place on record our deep thanks to Chandra for having taken care of NCL in this interim period. Thank you, Chandra, for having agreed to take care of the NCL leadership in this particular time. Ashish, we are all here with you and we look forward to your leadership in the coming time. Thank you all very much.
कार्यक्रम की अगली कड़ी में बढ़ते हुए मेरा निवेदन है माननीय डॉक्टर मार्चेलकर सर से कि वे इस अवसर पर हमें कुछ आशीर्वचन दें।
थैंक यू वेरी मच। और मैं टीचिंग जो कि कर लिया है फिनिश शिवराम पार्वती स्वामी चंद्रा और दी distinguished participants, friends of NCL, as I would say, friends of family of NCL, I would say, ladies and gentlemen who are joining it. It's a very special day. I'm very happy to be a part of this celebration just before coming here. It was so wonderful to meet Ashish and make him sit in the chair which I occupied from 1989 to 1995, and subsequently was occupied. I took a photograph of myself with him, which I'll be tweeting very soon. It will be one of the proudest moments of my life. So, Ashish, all our blessings, Ashirvad, as we draw upon. I'll just focus on two or three points. I think first, you all know Ashish, but you must know him well. I met Ashish in 1988 when I was a visiting professor at the University of Delaware. And I was teaching some undergraduate courses in process fluid mechanics, but also postgraduate one, transporting structured continuum, if you remember, which you attended. That was the time I met Ashish. Ashish's scholarship was known because he was a gold medalist of ICT. And just now, Shekhar talked about the promise of ICT. I would also add Shekhar, IICT, apart from ICT, IICT, University of Kanpur, as well as NCL. I think these are the four main players. Now, there, I remember his meeting a promise to me that he will come back and join NC. He had offered Shekhar from Procter & Gamble, from DuPont, two of the world's leading agencies, I mean, corporates, and refused them and came and joined as a scientist. I appreciate that. That was a big sacrifice. Yet then another sacrifice, I hope you will realize the kind of position he was occupying in Reliance, and he's taking a haircut of almost half a crore. Please understand that. But he has responded to our call, he has responded to Shekhar's call, he has responded to Nation's call, and he has come and joined because NCL is his heart. So I thought I will introduce you to him because nobody else will do that. In the way that I'm taking the liberty of doing that. The second point I want to make is that I think Ashish, your speech was absolutely motivating. I wish you had done it the same way as I had done on 1st June 1989. Suram, I have the photograph here.
I saw that.
Of the first day. Well, you remember this. And I remember our auditorium capacity is 500 plus, and there were 1,000 plus people there. And you can see some of them standing there. Alright. And that time, we all together, Paul, Suram, all of us,
I sat at
the
coffee of
that
presentation.
Yes, you know that. You know, at that time we dreamt on what we are going to do. And in 1995, when they gave me permission to go to Delhi from Pune, I remember recalling that speech, saying where we succeeded and where we failed, and why, basically. Not blaming others, but what is it that we were basically missing. I wish we had this function in the auditorium, because there is nothing like it. But I think the times are what they are, and we are dealing with the new normal. There is one more important point I want to make. NCL will do well in chemistry, it will do well in chemical technology, polymer technology, all that Ashish said is right. But please understand, NCL is beyond that. I'll just give you some sort of illustrations. NCL thinks big. Aspirations are our possibilities. Our aspirations, we are always kept high. I remember the very first talk that we have talked about, given, was that National Chemical Laboratory has to be international chemical. We said, what are we selling? What is our market? This was at a time when we say that 0 years practice. In 39 years, we had 0 years practice. And thanks to Paul, thanks to Sivram, we started exporting that market. It looked impossible because it was impossible. In fact, I had mentioned General Electric in my talk, and somebody came to me and said, and I said, we will license our patents to General Electric. And the person said, do you know General Electric's R&D budget is 2.5 times India's R&D budget? And I said, you know, the power of budget, but power of ideas. And then, thanks to Sivram's leadership, in 1992, we were able to license 3 US patents close to $1 million. That's why we were transporting. That is the spirit. That's the first. Second is, any action that we have taken has created national rates. For example, what the GE partnership was found, that was when they said, if they're so good, why are we not there? That is where the Japanese R&D center came. Then the other centers came up. And today India is global research and development platform. I remember during the Thapar Memorial lecture with Dr. Manmohan Singh had chaired in 1994, India emerges as a global R&D platform where we are talking about this journey, and you can see what has happened. What I'm trying to make is that what NCL does is think big and has roots. I remember we talked in my very first speech, if you remember, Suram had talked about nonsense club. Ideas, you know, which are out of the box, we should create that. I talked about Kaikunai Park, we created that. When I went as a DG to CSIR, we created new idea. And the extension of that at the national level was the building and Indian Technology Leadership Region, which has been the biggest public-private partnership, all right, which has stirred the entire nation. People say nothing like that has happened so far. You remember Sivram and Paul, you remember Himani, I hope he's listening. 24 July 1991, you know, Dr. Manmohan Singh got up as the Prime Minister and utilized India. You remember that? And within a month, you remember Sriram, Diwani, all of us said, what will NCR be in the post-liberalized? And then the rest of the body is followed. What will it be in the post-liberalized India? Because import duties would be slashed, and then we can't compete anymore. You know, because we can't be just bringing imports of chicken, coffee, and producing products. So therefore, that strategy, we were ahead of that. I remember, you know, people used to call me a Weimar director. Right? Any idea that you bring to me, I would say Weimar. And remember, young Nirvani, I hope he's listening. He came to my room and said, "Sir, there is a World Bank this thing on reforming some Chinese institutions, chemical institutions, Nanjing Suto, if I remember correctly. Can we build one? We have never done that." And I remember our going, because we said also we have to be knowledge-based consultancy organization. And we beat after we gave systems, international development panels and won that. And the Nandanathan, that that's what I told you, that it's the first consultancy contract from India to China. In CLDP. Always ahead of the curve. I want to remind you of that. Not just the excellence in science and technology, you have to show the way. For example, now one talked about the venture sector. You know, when Dr. Sriram was the director, I was in Delhi as a DG, the venture center was created. I still remember, I think Sir Richard Friend inaugurated it. I have that photograph. And Dr. Premda gave such fantastic leadership. It is not just incubating, it is creating a new wave. Yesterday you had a fantastic function, I understand. So 135 participants from all around the country. It's amazing. So what has happened is that that center actually has become kind of a go center for innovation. It is not just a sort of venture center, it's an adventure center, I would say. Alright, I think we should change the name. I'm telling you about this spirit which one of the tributes you have paid to me when I departed, because I read the speech, was one of his greatest gifts to CSR, to NCR, is the NCR Research Foundation. I remember that, and you said also why. Because a single rupee we could not get to say something, somebody went up. And we made in the beginning more, you remember, for the Christian, we created that. And that is a fantastic thing of sort of promoting. And CSR was opposed to it, by the way. I got it in writing with the founder, who really wrote to me. And I said, we'll do it. NCR does it, by the way. That's the basic issue. And then, similarly, we talk about Atmanirbhar Bharat today. We are already in Atmanirbhar Bharat. If you look at the military program and fuel cells, all right, and the remarkable work that Ashish has done, made, and NCR, Sikri, Kanai Kuri, NPL, all of you participated, it's phenomenal. And there, what is most interesting and most important is that even the vendor development work for every component, so that we are fully Atmanirbhar. So I always say, in my speeches, that making India. You get the point? And this is a splendid thing of Atmanirbhar Bharat being ahead of the time. Suggest that your responsibility, you know, we charge you to ensure that this decade will be known as decade of CSR, which our DG is already sort of for setting up. In fact, I've told him already, you will go down to the history of the best DG, CSR. I want to go down as the best director plus group 4 scientists. I'm shocked that there are only 100. What's happening? How can you beat all these big dreams if you are shunned like this? I think you have to revisit, reinvent. I'm being very blunt. I found that some 15 to 20 top scientists have met NCR during the last 5 years. this is not done. And remember, don't get confused, science should be always the priority of the NCR Bellary. Our technologies will be based on high science, like Paul showed us the way, Sikram showed us the way, you know, you showed us the way, you did high science. In fact, the takeover was a very interesting one, Infosys Science Award, which is Alpha Crown Award, is the highest science award by the way. One director, IICT, Infosys Science Award, gave the chance to another director, Infosys Science Award. That's the point, Shekhar, that's what we have to build. Great scientists who are doing cutting edge science, we are doing breakthrough technologies ahead of the rest of them. That's what we have to do. So that's message to you. I think you can't have a better combination than Dr. Shekhar Mandi in Delhi and Dr. Ashish Leary here. You can't have a better combination than that. The ball is in your court, basically. To perform, I recollect my sentence. I had said in 1999 when I left, NCR is a priceless sparkling diamond. I'm quoting from CSR necklace. The sparkle has gone down a bit. Or maybe some will say quite a lot. You have to bring it back. It's as simple as that. The last point I would make is the following. Because I picked up my old lecture and I was reading, and then I called Prabhakar in the morning. I remember, you remember that I had said that we will leave the laboratory and hopefully none of you leave at 5:30 and none of you come at 9:30. I hope so. So 9, what is your serving time?
9.
9. None of you come at 9 and go at 5:30. You know, research has to be a way of life. I remember I used to work here until 9:30 and go home. Nights were burning because I was sitting, staying in director's bungalow, and 12:30, 1 o'clock, if I get up, I would walk in the dark. And lights were burning. I want those lights to burn. You understand? There has to be a new life to CSM. And the last point I'd like to make is that as we come in, you know, if you read that statement, the purpose of this award. To advance technical science and to use it for the good of the people. So simple formula is that when you enter the laboratory, you read that, get inspired and say, I'm going to do something for the people of the to advance knowledge. And while we're leaving, at that time I had said 600 rupees per day. Then I calculated from Prabhakar by getting the figures in the morning because I don't want to make a mistake. It is 6,000 rupees per day. Okay? Basically. So each one of you should ask, what have I done? This poor country has, we're still a poor country, but what have I done for NCR, for CSR, for our nation? And if we do that, if each one of us sort of do that in a team NCR fashion, team CSR fashion, I believe we will move India up in the committee of nations, a spot that it has always deserved. Thank you.
पहले तो मैं अपनी प्रखर स्मरण शक्ति की दाद देना चाहूंगी कि आपको कई वर्ष पुरानी घटनाएं वो बहु याद है और सबसे बड़ी बात की आपने जो एनसीएल के बारे में बारीकियां बताई निश्चित रूप से उसका फायदा एनसीएल के सभी वैज्ञानिकों को माली निदेशक को होगा जो आगे इसमें प्रगति में सहायक होगा और जो आप एनसीएल के आधार स्तंभ रहे हैं ये हमारे लिए बहुत भाग्य की बात है सर इससे आप प्रखर वैज्ञानिक तो है ही ये तो कोई बोलने की बात नहीं है लेकिन इससे बढ़कर मैं कहना चाहूंगी कि आप एक मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर भी हैं जब आप बोल रहे थे तो एक एक शब्द बहुत ज्यादा मोटिवेट कर रहा था और कुल मिलाकर आपका सार कहूँ जो आपने कहा है तो आप ये कहना चाह रहे थे कि देश हमें देता है सब कुछ हम भी तो कुछ देना सीखे तो जिस वजह से हमको यहाँ बैठने मिला है या सैलरी मिली है तो हम अपने आप का हर क्षेत्र में बात लागू होती है कि हम अपने आप का मूल्यांकन करें कि हमने अपने सर्विस को या अपने देश को या अपने संस्थान को क्या दिया निश्चित रूप से आपकी बातें हमारे लिए बहुत प्रेरक रही हैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपकी उपस्थिति ही अपने आप में एक बहुत बड़ा वरदान है हम सबके कार्यक्रम की अगली कड़ी में सादर आमंत्रित करना चाहूंगी हमारे माननीय डॉक्टर शिवराम सर को जो भी एनसीएल के जो एक आधार स्तंभ सर रहे हैं और सर की कार्यशैली की चर्चा हम निरंतर सुनते आए हैं आपसे, इस अवसर पर कुछ सुनना चाहेंगे माननीय डॉक्टर शिवराम सर।
बहुत धन्यवाद डॉक्टर मशेलकर, डॉक्टर शेखर मांडे, DCSIR, पॉल रत्ना स्वामी। आई ऑल्सो सॉ अश्विनी इन द स्क्रीन फ्यू मिनट्स अगो। श्रीवरी फ्रॉम हैदराबाद, आशीष माय डियर फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम NCL विथ हूम आई एम ऑलवेज इन टच ऑलमोस्ट डेली विथ समबडी या द अदर। What a wonderful day this is! What a wonderful day this is! And first of all, to see you as this leader of this great institution, I think Mashirkar has said everything that needs to be said. I wish you the very best. Some of us are old, so we may have this tendency to advise you, but make sure that choose the right advice and throw away the not so good advice.
You don't have to say the word. We're all young.
So you will see the reason is that I once went to CDRI, that was about 4 years ago, to give a talk when DKC was the director there. And in the audience was 4 directors, okay, starting from the earliest one, you know. And so I asked him, how do you survive with 4 directors around you all the time, you know? So he said, no, it's a great thing to see them, you know. And they said they come on every occasion that we celebrate, all of them come, you know, which is, I think, he said he was so proud that some of them at that time was, almost. Yeah, how old is he?
93.
93, you know, and right up to Sia Gupta, you know, he must also be 80 now, you know. And everybody is in between is also alive, you know, I mean, in CDRI, the directors. So they all come, you know, on any event that the lab organizes, they all come and sit in the audience, you know, and it's a great thing. And the same thing I've seen in many CSIR, which I think is a laboratory, which in fact I went to give a talk in this Trivandrum just before the pandemic, and I saw 3 directors, none other than Vijay Nair and the present director, you know, and of course, Professor Ravi Charles at the time. He was 90, you know, right in the audience. And it was, it's such a touching, thing that people have so much love and affection for this institution. For me, personally, this is a very David filled with memories. The first time I saw a director taking over was when Dr. Mashirkar took over as director of this laboratory. So, I mean, in fact, this morning he sent me the event that I organized, because Paul was unfortunately at that time not well. And so I organized as a farewell. Paul was in the hospital at that time, you know, having just undergone his bypass. Yeah. And I had this, therefore on his behalf, I had organized his favor. So I saw him taking over. I also saw him leaving us for CSIR. So I think it is an emotional day for me. And of course, I've seen so many other directors taking over in the last few years. Shekhar talked about ICT, IICT, IIT. I don't know whether Shekhar is there. I just want to tell Shekhar that if I just leave out the first 2 directors who are expatriate directors of NCL, if I take the next 9 directors, 4 of them have come from ICT. So I think, with due apology, Shekhar, 3 of them have come from IITs. So you are right, you know, ICT. In fact, I used to say that the DNA of NCL is the DNA of ICT, you know. And I think because Dr. Venkatraman brought the DNA here, you know, from ICT in 1954. And I think that's an amazing, institution of DNA that has sustained us for long. I grew up listening to this great man here, and I was very young. relatively. We are only 5 years apart, but you know, he looks so older to me, you know. In terms of wisdom. Okay. I watched him unfold his dreams on that day in 1989, and it was electrifying. And I had just joined NCL from a different world, and I was wondering, what am I supposed to be doing here, you know, in this institution. And I heard him on that day, I think it was, you know, it sets our eyes so high that we could never go wrong, you know, because I always say that if you set your eyes very high, you can never go wrong, you know. You can fall short, of course, that's acceptable, but you will never go wrong. And I think that's what this gentleman who is sitting here today, I'm extremely happy that he is here today, because I think this is the culture of this institution. And I also remember, and I truly appreciate that Ashish has been denied this privilege of speaking to this 1,000-odd people in a big auditorium, because I did that on 1st July 2002, and I think it must be there in some of the archives of this laboratory. And I think I had 1,000 people, you know, listening to me when I expounded what my idea of NCL in this journey, what I call this continuing journey, like what CNR calls this limitless ladder of excellence. And I think it is this journey of good to great that I think this lab will have to move on from year after year. And I think today it's a pleasure to see we see this gentleman. I met him as a very young man in 1993. And then, in 1999, I pulled him out of his, you know, what I call his comfort zone a little bit. And I said, well, you are an excellent scientist, but can we do something more than that, you know? And I pulled him out of that little comfort zone. Maybe, you know, he could have been a different person if I did not do that. Or maybe he's a different person because I did that. And therefore, it has been an outstanding journey for me, because I literally pulled him out of a little comfort zone in which he was existing. And I said, can we see the world a little broadly? And then when I got the confidence that he can do so, then I remember in 2005, when we came on and left this lab for Sikri Karaipudi, I needed somebody to manage this fuel cell program, because I was a passionate supporter. I started this program in 2002 in NCL. And I said, I need somebody who can organize and run this program. Ashish had no clue, am I right, of what fuel cell was at the time. But I said, we don't need prior expertise. All we need is an attitude that we can do it. And I asked him, will you take on this challenge? And as I said, he accepted, he never said no. So, and the rest is history, you know, as far as I'm concerned, because he has just come back building one of the greatest and the biggest ambitious hydrogen roadmap for this country. You know, so you can see here how that journey has led him to a process where he can now talk about a policy for this country. And I think that's what NCL, and the same thing happened to me when I came in, when Dr. Mashirkar, you know, gave me that opportunity and said, think big and grow big, you know, and I think we all have enjoyed that privilege. And I hope that Ashish, you will create a new breed of people who will think big, you know? Not only you, but younger people who will then lead this country after 20 years. Because I think we need continuing leadership in science and technology in India. And I think as one generation passes, a new generation has to take over, you know. And they should have the audacity of imagination. That's what Dr. Mashirkar brought us at a very young age to this organization. And I hope that we bring in people who have the audacity to imagine. And whether they deliver or not is something else, but I think they must have the audacity. If without audacity, you never make any beginning. So I hope that the hopes of a nation, I think all of us have talked about it, Mashirkar has talked about it, I think lies very heavily on your shoulder. Because NCL is not, okay, NCL is an important organization, CSIR, but people look at NCL beyond CSIR, you know. And I think some of us who have been privileged to be part of NCL, we know what respect we get outside when we say we are formerly from NCL. And I think today, if I have the last 10 years of hindsight that I have lived my life, the respect that I get in industry, in my everywhere I go, academia, is basically because of the fact that we are part of NCL. That is what NCL is all about. That's a culture. The people, when you meet the people, like you said, ambassadors, you know, they recognize you as a product of an institution. That is a great institution. So I think this people, you know, we don't realize it. We are somewhat more self-critical than we should be. But agree that within the house, we should be very self-critical. But the world outside looks at NCL with great awe and expectations. And I think we need to fulfill the expectations. I think especially the industry in India, the academia in India, I mean, they all look at this institution with great expectation. And they know that people of this institution are good scientists, they are good people with vision, they are good people with ideas. And I think that's what we all are valued for in this nation today. The task is clear cut for you. I think you have expressed it very beautifully in the last few minutes. I think what you need to do, and I think we live in a little bit of a depressing environment, both as a nation and as an institution. I think the first task is to, just like what Mashalkar did, show us the stars. By the way, 1989-90 was also a very depressing environment. Very depressing.
In fact, in 1991, we did not have money to pay electricity.
And I tell you, and we were, and Dr. Mashalkar called me one day, and he said, you cut the library budget by 60%, you know. In those days, of course, we were only dependent upon print journals. And I remember spending weeks and weeks and weeks, that's a big journal I should cut. The reason is because the rupee went from, you know, I mean, something like 14 rupees to a dollar to 36 rupees to a dollar. And he called me one day at his office, and I was the chairman of the library committee, and he said, please cut the library budget to 60%. I would be 40% for the year. I said, should I cut General American Chemical Society, General Union Ministry, Macro Monuments? What should I cut? And I remember. So what I'm saying is that, let's not think that today we are going through a lot of difficulties, financial, environmental issues that are like the pandemic, but I think I always believe that a crisis is an opportunity, and I think Dr. Mashalkar showed us the way. I think crisis is an opportunity, and I think only when we are driven to the wall that we are really innovating. You know, honestly speaking, in comfort, we are not innovating, you know. And in fact, the history of science tells us that the best discoveries, including the discoveries that happened in the last 1 year, happened only when there's a crisis. And the best discoveries came during the World Wars I and II. Okay? And you couldn't imagine a discovery of a mRNA vaccine happening any time within 1 year in the normal course of time. You know, I mean, it could not have happened. 100 people have raised 1,000 objections. Why you cannot get that? And so that's, I think, crisis is a great opportunity to innovate. And I think you have to raise the morale and spirit of the people at first. I think there is a little bit of a depressing feeling amongst our colleagues that maybe our opportunities are not right at NCL. I think we need to tell them that the sky is the limit as far as NCL goes. And you have to become a spokesman for Indian science. And not only in academia and industry, and that requires a lot of outreach. You have to get out of your chair in the office in order to, of course, I'm hoping that environment will change overall. There's nothing like going and physically talking to people across the table, like in podiums, across audiences. And I think that's important, you know, if you want visibility for the institution. And so see what in partnership, whether it's industry, whether in government, whether it's civil society, with partnership, what we can achieve. And I think that is what I think you will have to. And lastly, I think Mashalkar has made the statement that you have to nurture uncompromising excellence. I think that's what we learned in our life. Because excellence only breeds excellence. Mediocrity breeds mediocrity. Let's be honest about it. So excellence breeds excellence. So once you have 10 good people, you you don't have to worry. Those candidate people will bring another candidate better. And so you need that kind of uncompromising quality is something that you have to. Nothing saying that this is good for us. No, you know. You can't say this is good enough for NCA. You know. I mean, there is no such benchmarks. Okay, we need to get the best of the people. I also feel so sad that, you know, 2025 of outstanding. By the way, they are all doing exceedingly well in this country. You know, and they left us because we couldn't sustain the excellence of that institution. And all of them, by the way, are today considered as stars in the firmaments of chemistry. And that's what we had and we lost. So, well, four walls of an institution do not make an institution. We all know that. I think it is the quality of the people that create an institution. So we can have the best of the buildings and the best of the infrastructure. In fact, in the recent incident that happened in Ashoka University, it's what everybody said, four walls of a glitzy institution do not make an institution. You know, it is our ability to sustain the excellence within the institution, you know, of the people that makes an institution. So I think you have to sustain great men, women, and everybody else in this organization. Maybe more women than men. And I think you have to build in the diversity. You know. I also say that excellence generates tensions within the organization. But these are healthy tensions. We should not shy away from tensions. We can have a bunch of yes men and one can be very comfortable. But I think when you have excellent people that question you, I think that questioning is what makes the institutions. And I always say that for every LPD, there was an RAM. All right? For every Shivaram, there was a VDK. Okay. All right? And for every Ashish, there was a Prerna. Okay? The reason is that they are questioned, you know. Okay? I mean, because they are men of exceptional intellectual quality. They are not, it doesn't mean that by questioning we are, you know, demeaning somebody. We are only asking him for the better institution. I have benefited from such great people around me who used to question me every day, are you doing this right? Is this the way it should be done? And I think, I tell you, we have improved consistently, you know, in this process. And I think it's important to sustain men of all caliber, you know, not just somebody who agrees with me or somebody of the thing. To be these, build healthy tensions in the organization, to be there the foundations of an institution. Similarly, resources, I have already emphasized, are not the constraint anymore or anywhere in the world to build a great institution. I think it is ideas. If we don't have ideas, hopefully we will have some resources we can have plenty. I think we need to have big ideas, ability to think big, dream. I think if our dreams are large enough, money and resources will come. Let's not talk about resources first. Let's talk about ideas first. I think most of us in this country, we suffer by lack of ideas. And not because of lack of money. And today I see even most starker as I sit in many forums and committees and everywhere. Money is not limiting. Money is available. But what are we getting? Are we getting, you know, I mean, great ideas, you know, which is what I think is limiting. So Ashish, pardon me if it's a bit of an advice. This is the perils of old age. So pack the organization with exceptional men and women. Okay. I think Ashish can explore. And this organization will be a lot of fun. I had no problem for 10 years. I had such exceptional men around me, women around me, that I didn't have to do much. Dream large and wide, and you see how the magic transforms an institution. And above all, I say, this is something that I have learned. It's how to stop the paradox. I don't know how many of you know how to stop the paradox. You know, beware, and above all, understand the stop the paradox. What is stop the paradox? Maintain your unwavering faith that you can and will prevail in this end, regardless of the difficulties. And at the same time, have the courage to confront the most brutal facts of your current life. It's very important. Dr. Mashekar used to tell me that the streets of Delhi are paved with banana peels. Okay? So he used to tell me that the only way you survive in Delhi, one of the reasons why I never went to Delhi. So he scared me. But he says you have to make sure that you don't step on the banana peels. You know? So I think Muhammad Ali, the great boxer, said that you know, if you cannot bear the pain of the pebbles, you cannot climb a mountain. So because before you climb a mountain, there are lots of pebbles. Pebbles hurt you more than the way on your feet. So Muhammad Ali once said that if you cannot bear the pain of the pebbles, you can never climb a mountain. So if you have to climb a mountain, you have to face realities. And the realities are brutal, but I think that's where the self-care paradox comes in. And make sure that in spite of the realities, you have this unwavering faith in your power, in the institutional strength that you have, and an ability to do great things in this country. So thank you, Ashish, and as a token of my little thing, the book is an interesting book, it's called Chemistry. Okay, now, there was somebody who dared to write a novel with the name Chemistry. You know, Chemistry is not about attractive, you know, because most people don't like chemistry at all nowadays. So this is actually a debut novel, and it's written by a person who did a PhD in chemistry. So it's a she, and she has created a novel about you know, what is the life beyond the laboratory is what we need to think of, you know. And so enjoy reading it. And
so before somebody does a note of thanks, I give only 90% of my motivation. I had a couple of lives. When I went to Ashish's room and sat down, he and I were sitting in the same positions where Sinharao and I were sitting. So Mr. Sinharao was the chairman of our research advisory council. The very first meeting, sit down, he told me, he used to call me Ramesh. Ramesh, your number of weaknesses, one of your greatest weakness is that you like to be very popular. You like to be liked by people. That's the first thing you should stop doing. The second, he said, I have an aspiration for you, not just for NCI. He said, you must become a fellow of our society. Now, Ashish, I give you the first advice, I have to give you the second. Because not if you do it, when you do it. In these 60 years, there are only 3 million scientists from India. Dr. Narasimha, who is Momo, M.M. Sharma, our guru, and myself. But there are only 2 million Indians. You have become fellow of our society in 60 years. I want you to be informed. The Institute of Chemical Engineering, University, all 3 of us will belong there, and 2 of us will belong to ANC. So that is the last part of my motivational speech. Please will include that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
आपको बोल रहे थे तो उससे अंदाजा लग रहा था कि आपने किन कठिनाइयों में कितने कम रिसोर्सेज में काम किया है. और निश्चित रूप से हमारी नई पीढ़ी को यह बहुत कुछ सीखने लायक है कि किस प्रकार से कठिनाइयों से पार पाया जा सकता है. और जैसा कि आपने बताया कि हर आपदा अपने आप में, जैसे कि मोदी जी का भी मूल मंत्र है जो मोदी जी ने हमें दिया है कि हर आपदा में एक अवसर छुपा होता है, उस अवसर को पहचान कर हमें आगे बढ़ना चाहिए और एक अच्छा एनवायरमेंट भी हम बना सकते हैं. तो आपके पहले प्रश्नों के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. और निश्चित रूप से एनसीएल जैसी संस्था को आपने अपने अंदर में जिया है, आपके बातों से एहसास हो गया कि एक जब किसी व्यक्ति का बहुत ज़्यादा जुड़ाव हो जाता है तो वो संस्था उसके अंदर ही समाहित हो जाती है. और मैं ये कहना चाहूँगी कि आज एक बहुत अभूतपूर्ण क्षण है कि डॉक्टर आशीष लेले, आदरणीय सर पाटेकर सर और आदरणीय शिवराम सर, तीनों एक साथ बैठे हुए हैं. और हमारे माननीय डी जी सर, प्रोफेसर नांगिया, चंद्रशेखर जी और विजय मोहन जी, इनकी और डॉक्टर पॉल रत्न स्वामी की ऑनलाइन उपस्थिति है और आप सब यहाँ साक्षात बैठे हुए हैं. तो एक बहुत बड़ा अवसर है अपने आप में, एक अभूतपूर्व अवसर. बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद सर. और कार्यक्रम के अंतिम क्षण में बढ़ते हुए मैं निवेदन करना चाहूँगी माननीय डॉक्टर जोशी सर से कृपया वोट ऑफ थैंक्स प्रस्तुत करें.
चंद्रशेखर, आशीष, former directors, colleagues, students, they can enter. It's my great privilege and honor to propose the Board of Finance. It is indeed a special occasion for all of our time. Dr. Lurley, who is a product of NCL, is taking over the director of NCL, and our groups, Dr. Mashankar, Dr. Shivram, are gracing the event with their presence. It's a really special occasion in the history of NCL. Dr. Mashankar, sir, I'm one of the fortunate guys who listened to your talk and took over the director of the NCL. And I do remember, as Dr. Shivram said, it was elected one. Absolutely, it was elected one. Very inspired. The whole organization was like charge. And after more than 3.5 decades, your talk is still motivating me. It's always a great experience. It's really inspiring, and as I said before, I have been several of your talks. I really feel sorry for some of my colleagues who are missing your talks. I should have also really fortunate that there are very few, I think, in the audience who are fortunate to move. Probably that means I'm getting over that question. So we are really thankful to you. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We wish to have your blessings. You can be taken out of NCL, right? Dr. Mashankar is NCL, NCL Dr. Mashankar. So I know you will be with us forever. And Dr. Shishir will have the guidance of the Dr. Shivram during his tenure. I would like to express our heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Shivram for this occasion, thanking us for the leadership of us, and I'm sure I should think forward to the guidance from you two scholars.
Bhugo GST Silla Patel.
I would like to thank Dr. Shekhar Mande, our DG, during valuable time. He's got a very busy schedule, that it's really great that he could spend some time with us. And,
yes, absolutely. One out of the way to create this space up, I
think.
He's among the top 5 busiest men in the country.
So it shows how much faith he has in the excellent blessing which he would like to have.
Jeez,
yeah, that's right. Last 4 months have been really difficult for NCL. We faced several challenges. We dealt with finance situations, there are financial constraints, several legal land issues, and I would like to give a big thanks to Dr. Chandrasekhar, who has exhibited full support, encouragement, shown the leadership. Even though he was not at NCL, he was always available. And I really thank Dr. Chandrasekhar for your leadership role during these 4.5 months.
Chandra is a good boy.
So, thank you.
Yeah,
no doubt, it's fortunate to have a director like you in such difficult times. And personally, I really enjoyed working with you, Dr. Joshi.
Thanks, Joshi. Thank you so much.
I would like to thank all heads of the divisions, our sectional heads, administration, finance, accounts, stores, purchase, giving full support. So it has been difficult because it's unanswerable in the financial issues and so on. Support and you could run our institute for 4 months without any hiccups. So I'm thankful to all of them. I would like to thank all our colleagues, Mr. K.D. Deshpande, Sunil, and Swati, who have helped us to organize this event. It's a really short time because Ashok was really contemplating whether he should join immediately or take a break. And he said, no, I want to stand on the first of it. So I said, that's not a problem. So I'm thankful to all of them. I'm also thankful to Deepak and Asha. The last 4 months, they have been really a good support system for all of us. Finally, I would like to thank all our colleagues, friends, students who are virtually connected to us, who attended this function and made it successful. Thanks. Thanks.
Shiny, what time is it there? Can't hear you.
Sorry, I was muted. 1:45 a.m. 2 o'clock.
Good night, good night. Don't sleep, don't sleep.
धन्यवाद. इसी के साथ कार्यक्रम समाप्ति की घोषणा करती हूँ. एक बार पुनः बहुत सारी शुभकामनाओं के साथ और
थैंक यू।